Lesson 2. Arabia's prevailing political conditions. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Allahumma akhrijna min zulumati al-wahm. Wa akrimna bi nur al-fahm. Allahumma aftah alayna abwab rahmatik. Wa anshur alayna khazaina ulumik. Bi rahmatika ya arhamar rahimin. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Welcome to Lesson 2, Arabia's Prevailing Political Conditions of Module 2 on the Prophetic Period in Medina of the course on Siratul Nabi. In the previous lesson, we talked about the Prophet's emigration to Medina. The Arabs belong to one ethnic race, but history does not record that they were ever united as one nation. They were divided into tribes and clans, each having its own chief or chieftain. They no doubt spoke the same language, but each tribe followed a different dialectal variation. Indeed, even religion was not a binding force. Almost every house had its own god. Tribes had their own supreme deities. In the south were the small principalities of Himyar, Auza, and Aqyal. In the middle and northern Arabia lead the tribes of Bakr, Taghlib, Shayban, Azd, Qudaa, Khandaf, Lahm, Khuzam, Banu Hanifa, Tay, Asad, Hawazin, Ghatfan, and Aus, Khazraj, Thaqif, Quraysh, and others. They were frequently engaged in intensive warfare. Bakr and Taghlib had been fighting each other for 40 years, as an instance. Blood engagements had ruined many a tribe of Hadramaut in today's Yemen. Aus and Khazraj had exhausted themselves through a protracted war and the Battle of Fijar, which we discuss in Module 1, between the Banu Qais and Quraysh had not yet ended. If any member of a tribe was killed, the tribe considered itself duty-bound to seek revenge, not merely upon the murderer, but also on the tribe to which he belonged. Since there was no effective machinery to settle such disputes, this invariably touched off furious wars which lasted for generations. Tribal might, dash, and alacrity were the only guarantee of a precarious security. The desert and the hills were the home of fierce nomadic tribes who lived largely on plunder and desperation, but trade was also a major source of livelihood for them. Only a few months of the year were regarded as sacred. It was only then that bloodshed was stopped in order to facilitate the performance of the annual pilgrimage to Mecca or to do trade at Ukaz. But even this convention was at times relaxed to suit the convenience of individual tribes. Only the precincts of the Kaaba were considered sacred and were free from bloodshed. It is to this state of affairs that the Quran has drawn attention. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alam yaraw anna ja'ala haraman amina wa yutakhattafu an-nasu min hawlihim. Do they not see that we have made the sacred territory secure for them, while men are carried off by force all around them? The conditions in the country were so insecure that even Till 5 after Hijrah, the powerful tribe of Abdul Qais of Bahrain could not think of going to Hijaz outside the sacred months. Even the caravans going to or returning from Syria were sometimes plundered in open daylight. Muslims' pasture lands were at times raided. All the conditions had considerably improved by then. The road to Mecca from Medina was not altogether safe until the fall of Mecca in 8 after Hijrah. While the country was so strife-ridden internally, dangers from outside were no less. The Roman and Persian empires had extended their domain to the fertile provinces of Yemen, Oman, and Bahrain, and had established their sovereignty over them. The Romans had occupied Syria, Ghazan, and some other Arab tribes who had embraced Christianity had been set up as the latter's feudatories. The Romans had expelled the Jews from Syria and Palestine in the 2nd century before the Common Era. These Jews had migrated to Medina, called Yathrib before, and its suburbs, and built strong fortresses at Medina, Khaybar, Taima, Fadak, and other places. Prospering themselves, the Jews were extremely jealous of prosperity in other races and strongly resented rivalry in trade business. They believed themselves to be God's chosen people, and their conduct was characterized by pride and arrogance, intensified by the feeling of being secure inside the formidable fortresses. It was during such times that the Prophet started his great mission. For preparing the ground and the proper climate, the first step that he took was to unite the Ansar and the Muhajirun. Next meeting, we will deal with the pact with the Jews, inshallah. For more similar lessons, subscribe to Wayfaring with Mansoor channel. Thank you. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.